Whack.
I have been in hibernation for a few months, and then I wake up to this? And in my slow process to make this video, more staff are leaving. Let's just start with the fact that Japan Studio is, or I guess not was, one of Sony's best first party studios, and it can even be debatable as to Japan Studio being the best first party studio that Sony has. I mean had. They have created legendary titles such as the Ape Escape series, The Legend of Dragoon, Ico, Shadow of the Colossus, and The Last Guardian, the Locoroco games, Patapon, Echo Chrome 1 and 2, Last Sky, Puppeteer, Go, Sports Ski, Rain, Freedom Wars, the Siren series, Astro Bot Rescue Mission, and Astro's Playroom, Gravity Rush 1 and 2, and last but not least, Knack. And those are just some of the big games. They have made many more and have collaborated or insisted in some way on a huge list of other games. Let's just name a few, like Everybody's Golf series, the White Knight Chronicle series, and perhaps The Rapper. That went along with the responsibility of external production, software localization, and IP management. But now, instead of having Japan Studio make amazing games and help other Japan studios make great games for PlayStation, they are now just going to be a significantly smaller studio focusing on Astro Bot, while external Japanese studios will have to go through a global brand instead of a local one. Because that's how the rest of their branches operate, right? It's not like they have XDev focusing on Europe and PAL region, and the Santa Monica studio helps other developers in the US. No, of course not. This news is very upsetting as this studio has made legendary games and games that I very much enjoy. The only other Japanese studio left now is Polyphony Digital, I think that's how they're called, but whatever, all they do is make Gran Turismo. My interest in Sony has been dwindling for some time. It seems like the direction they're headed is not where my interests lie. I'm getting tired of a cinematic third-person action-adventure game being the template for every Sony exclusive because, for the most part, that seems to be their go-to nowadays. Meanwhile, I'm looking at other options that have different types of games. And while yes, I mean the PS3, I also mean the Atari CVS 800. Hey guys, I just want to let you know that COG Connected was the one behind the PlayStation Exclusives little montage thing. He has another one that drives a point further in his video about first-party PlayStation Exclusives, which I recommend because he talks about the same issues I've been going through this generation, which is that PlayStation Exclusives feel samey for the most part, and it's because they are, the big ones at least. But if you want a lighter video, check out my video on Go Sports Ski. It's a fun little game, and I'm going to try to make videos on more Japan Studio games, but you'll have to hang around for a while. Maybe give me another 3 months. I might have something by then. Or Sony will make another huge mistake. It'll be one of the two.